Vanakkam. Hi friends, welcome back to Nageshwari's kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how I grow garlic in my garden, and that too in Melbourne. In Melbourne weather it's hard to grow a few of the vegetables, but garlic it's easy. You can grow anytime, and I will show you the procedure that I follow. Let's get into the video. Before that, if you're watching Nageshwari's kitchen for the first time, please subscribe to Nageshwari's kitchen and press the notification bell symbol. You will get notified whenever I post my new videos. Let's get into the video. I've taken store-bought garlic, the whole garlic. This is around $20 per kilo, so I bought around half a kilo of garlic. Let's see how much of garlic I'm going to get at the end of this video. I will cover stage by stage how it goes, how the garlic is growing and everything. Try to use the organic garlic or Australian grown garlic. I will suggest not to use the China garlic. It's up to you. You can decide what you want to grow in your garden. Let's get in. So take whole garlic. What you have to do, just peel the skin. Just the outer layer, not everything, just the outer layer of the skin. That's all. This is done. And don't throw the skin, add it to your garden as well.
To your plants.
Yeah, to your plants. Today I removed the outer skin of this whole garlic. Now take a glass of water. So that this glass size must be smaller than your garlic. So if you keep your garlic, it should touch only, the water should touch only this area, not the whole garlic, just the bottom part, like this. Keep it like this and place this glass with the garlic near the window or where the sun is coming inside the house, near the window. Keep this glass of water and then the whole garlic. Keep place this near the window. So it will take like a week to get the, you will see the roots here and also the sprout.
I get sun near my kitchen window, so I always put the seedlings or seeds. If I'm trying anything new, everything, I just keep it here. So this is actually after 2 to 3 days the roots started to grow, but the sprouts, it's not came yet. I have kept like 3-4 days to see the difference, and I wanted to show you all the difference of each day. So I have kept like 2 days once the new ones, so you can see the difference of this garlic growth. See this one, it's growing so good, the roots are so healthy. So you can decide the growth of these garlics based on the root and the sprouts. If the garlic is spoiled, that means the garlic quality is not good, so you can decide based on that. So the roots are growing healthily without any issues.
This is after 4 days. Can you see the roots? The roots are coming up here, but still it's not, the sprouts are not started yet. It's going to sprout soon, but it's not started yet. This is actually after 4 days. This is after exactly, this is exactly after 10 days. Can you see the difference? Can you see the roots? How beautifully it's grown, and the sprouts are grown nicely as well.
The faster the roots come, the more healthy it is.
Yes. And still I have two more pots, two more cloves of garlic. It's still not sprouted yet, but it's ready to sprout. I'm going to plant this. So this is the right time to plant. Can you see?
On all of the garlic
It's all grown now. It's ready to go to the ground. You can plant this. I will teach you how to plant this as well. So I'm going to plant this. I will cover the growth of this garlic until the harvesting stage. I will cover every stage and then I'm going to combine all the videos together and then I'm going to post as a single video how to grow garlic. Garlic, if you want to grow without any issues in your garden, I will suggest garlic is the best option because you will not have any insects problem, no snails issues, nothing. Because of this garlic smell, no insects will come and eat this. No caterpillar, no snail, nothing. So you can happily, the garlic will grow happily without any issues. The important things that you have to follow is if you see any grass or weed is growing next to these plants, just remove it immediately, because when the garlic grows, the garlic on and the weed both look same, and don't do the same mistake that I did. I removed most of my garlic. I thought it's all weed and I removed it. Then I realized that's all garlic. I lost all my plants last year. So don't do that mistake. If you see any weed when it's in a small stage, you just remove it immediately. Then your garlic will grow really happily. Water this plant 2 days once regularly. In our Melbourne weather, it will take at least 6 months to harvest the garlic. I will cover all those videos.
So I'm going to remove each clove of garlic. I will show you how to do that now. Actually, I thought to do it yesterday, but because of some urgent work, so I couldn't do it. So I'm going to do it today. Each clove of garlic is grown so healthily without any issues, and the roots are looking so good, and also the sprouts also looking very healthy. So let's take it out of each pot of garlic. That is each clove of garlic. So when you remove, you have to be very careful. Don't do it like really hard or something. Just handle it very gently. If the skin of the garlic is came out, don't worry, that's not going to help for growth of the garlic. Just gently take out the each clove of garlic. So you must have some roots as well. So you have to remove it like this. So now we are going to add all these ones to our ground. So if the skin is peeling automatically, that is fine, but you don't have to remove it intentionally. So that's not required. I'm really, really happy to see these roots and can you see the health? It's looking so healthy. Even the small cloves of garlic is the roots came as well, and the plants also looking very good. So I will take out all of them and then we will go and add it in the ground. So for this garlic soil, I have not done any special preparation for this one, just as it is. As I always say, garden soil 60%, 20% coco peat and 20% potting mix. So the soil must be really loose, so it should not be really tight. So you can add little bit more percentage of potting mix. Do not add too much of garden soil. Garden soil will make the soil really hard. So for garlic, the underground vegetables you need the soil must be really loose. So make sure the soil is loose. Otherwise, when you it's really hard when you harvest the vegetables. So try to add in more of potting mix instead of garden soil. The coco peat also it's fine. So I have not added any fertilizer or anything For garlic, you don't need much because it's pest free. It grows very well. It grows like a weed, but it will take some time. It takes around 6 months at least to harvest garlic. But in India, I think it's 4 months or something. But in Melbourne, due to the weather, we need at least 6 months to harvest the vegetable. So my cloves of garlics are ready. So here is the place I always grow garlic. So in my house, you can see garlic plant throughout the year. So every time I'll just when my harvesting is finished, I will just add in the next batch immediately. So I will just top up some garden soil on top of that. That's all I normally do. So when you plant garlic, the spacing must be the diameter of your garlic. That's all you have to consider. Just maybe little bit extra of your garlic size. So other than that, you don't need to put too much of space. Just plant it closely, then you can plant more garlic in a small space. The garlic size, when you buy the garlic, you will know the diameter of garlic. So based on that, plant it accordingly. So I'm planting it here in a diagonal shape. So the first row and the second row, I'm just adding it in the like a diamond shape, so that I can put more garlic. I can grow more garlic. So you don't need any tools or anything, just dig to the height of the garlic cloves. That's all you have to consider. You don't have to put too much inside, just the height of the cloves of garlic, and then just dig in and then add in your garlic cloves. Just cover it with soil. That's all you have to do. Just arrange it nicely and remember the spacing. So in this small area, I have planted all my cloves of garlic. Can you see the soil? It is really loose. It should be loose. It must be loose. If the soil is really hard, it's hard to grow. So make sure the soil is loose. Now I'm going to finish all of them and then I'll show you how it looks like. I'll show you all of them. Even the garlic is not sprouted, still you can plant it. It will grow as well. You can skip all these methods and just you can plant your garlic straight away in the ground without rooting method. But it will take some more time. It will to get this stage. It will take at least 1 month to 1.5 months. We are saving so much of time just doing this method. So it's only 10 days. So you can see this growth inside the house itself. So we are saving time. That's why I'm doing this process. We can grow without doing this method as well. So it's up to you whether you want to do this method or you can just plant it as it is. But to me, this method is a fast process. That's why I follow this. I follow this method for like more than 4 years now. Last 4 years, I'm growing garlic always in my garden. So don't forget to add water 2 days once. Garlic will grow in winter also, so you don't have to worry about it. There is no fixed starting time or anything. I'm going to add a little bit of mulch. I have some leftover mulch from my garden bed. So I'm going to add in between these plants so that the moisture will stay. You can save some water as well. You can't add mulch to all the plants. There are some specific plants that you cannot add mulch, but for garlic you can add, and also it saves, you can save a lot of water. If you are growing your garlic in summer time, you must add this mulch to save the water. To save the water, and also it retains the moisture within the plant. So that's why I'm adding this. So this is the growth after like few weeks. So it's growing really healthily. There are some weeds is growing as well. I have to remove it. I will show you when I remove the weeds. So each and every clove of garlic is grown very nicely and without any issues. See, can you see each of them is grown so good? And also there are some weeds in between, so I have to remove that.
So we're growing garlic and there's some weeds and unwanted plants between the garlic. So we're gonna pull it so it doesn't take away the plants.
So the weeds and unwanted plants will take all the strength and the water. So we don't want that to happen. So we want the garlic to grow healthier, okay? So we want the garlic to grow healthier. That's why you have to remove
the weeds
and
unwanted plants.
Yes.
So me and my daughter came to garden to remove this weeds and unwanted plants that's growing in between my garlic plants. The garlic plant looks really healthy. It looks amazing. The growth of the garlic plant is very, very good. So when you remove the weeds, make sure you don't remove your garlic plant. So make sure you are removing only your weeds and unwanted plants. My daughter is really happy to help me with the gardening work. I always encourage my kids to do more gardening work, just to stay away from phone or mobile phones or TV or anything. So they will understand the importance and importance of vegetables and fruits, and also they'll do more physical activities.
To go outside and do gardening, so when they grow up to be a parent, they can do gardening and make the world healthier.
Yes, very good, Laithia.
Meanwhile, I was removing the weeds from other plants as well. You can see my turkey berry plant. It was really small, but now it's grown so big. So I'm just taking out all the weeds. Make sure you do that as well. After like few months, my plants were fallen off. It's due to the weather. We had like heavy wind like continuously 3-4 days. So all my garlic plant is fallen off. So I'm really worried. I don't know how the growth of the garlic is, but I'm going to leave it as it is. The plant should be like this. So this is the growth of, this must be the growth of the garlic. So if my plant is not fallen, so this is how it will look like. So this video is given by my friend Revati. She doesn't have any issues. Her garlic plant was really growing happily. So this is the flower of garlic. So it's not the real garlic that you're seeing on top. That's a flower of garlic. So this is how it will look like if the plant is not fallen. So this is the healthier version of garlic. When the flowers start to grow, the plant will start to become yellowish color. Then it's time to harvest.
Hi friends, today I'm going to harvest garlic. Actually, it's not the right time to harvest, but due to heavy wind, all my plants have fall off. So I have to harvest this, otherwise the garlics will get spoiled. So I will see how much growth is. I will show you what's the growth of my plants, and we'll see how much garlic I'm going to get.
I'm gonna dig the soil out and then take the garlic out.
So this is the condition of my garlic. So all my plants were dried and it's all fallen off. So it's this is because of the weather. So after doing all these things, I'm really worried about farmers. That's why I started to buy more vegetables and fruits directly from farmers. So you can understand the pain of farmers when they grow like in a big thing, if the weather is not helping them. So this is what will happen to them as well. See, the garlic looks so healthy, but the size of the garlic is small. It's because of the weather. So I was not able to take out the garlic properly. So I was digging each of them, and I will show you at the end of this video the how much garlic that I got. See, the garlic really healthy, but plant is died. That's why the garlic, it's not able to grow any more bigger in size. So I have to take it out. I will take out all of them, and then I will show you at the end of this video how much garlic that I got. So my daughter always curious of harvesting any vegetables. Whatever if I harvest, she will always come into the garden and ask for, is there any harvesting today, Amma? So she loves harvesting. So whenever I harvest something, she loves to come and look at the happy face. She she loves harvesting vegetables or fruits. So the garlic is looks really healthy, but the size of the garlic is very small. That's all. Other than that, I'm really happy whatever is that I got from my garden. So this is the garlic that we got. This is around 1.7 or something, but after it's dried, maybe it will come around 1.5 kilos of garlic. So I'll wash this thoroughly, and then I'm going to dry this for at least 1 week, and then I'm going to use it in my cooking. So I'll wash this, and then I'll show you how that it looks like. She is very happy to see the vegetables.
Hi friends. So I'm going to show you my garlic today. I dried this completely. I have dried this for around 4 to 5 days in the hot weather. So this is dried completely. I got around 1.5 kilos of garlic. I'm really happy. Due to the weather, I removed before the harvesting stage, but I'm happy that I got a fresh garlic from my garden. It's small garlics, but the taste is amazing. The aroma of fresh garlic always amazing. If you use in your cooking, you will see the difference. I actually realized about farmers. I'm worried about farmers because I'm growing this in my garden, and because of heavy wind, due to heavy wind, all my plants were collapsed. So I pushed to harvest 4 weeks before. That's why my garlic size is small. Otherwise, if you harvest after 4 weeks, you will get bigger garlic. As you buy from supermarkets, you will get big garlics as well. I was thinking about farmers, how they used to suffer if the weather is not good, or if something happened to their plants, all the growth of their vegetables or fruits, everything will get collapsed as well. So keep supporting farmers, so they should not suffer. We have to support them, grow more and get more from farmers as well. I'm happy that I got 1.5 kilos of garlic. If you try more different vegetables in your garden, please leave that in the comment section below, so everybody will get benefit out of it. I have shown from day one till harvesting. Please follow each steps. You can definitely grow garlic in your garden, and that too in Melbourne. So always growing at home is special. So grow more, stay healthy. I'm really happy to, I'm more excited to use these garlics in my cooking. This is my fourth time I'm growing in my garden these garlics. Last year I got actually big garlics, but this year due to weather, it's got small garlics, but still I'm happy. So it's all try and error method. So I have to always, I want to, this experience teached me to grow more actually. So it's not my fault, it's because of the weather. But anyway, I'm happy what I got. So I'm going to grow more garlic in future as well. So don't miss to grow this garlic in your garden as well. Grow more, you will get garlic is a pain-free gardening. If you want to do pain-free gardening, please grow garlic in your garden. So you will definitely be surprised the growth of this garlic, and you will not at all face any issues, insects or any issues. Insects will not come closer to garlic at all. So you can plant garlic without any troubles. Grow more, stay healthy. I hope you all enjoyed watching this video. I hope this video is informative and useful for you all. If you think so, please thumbs up and share with your friends. Please subscribe to Nageshwari's Kitchen. I will see you in another video. Bye.